SolidWorks provides plenty of options that you can control to personalize your user experience. In this video, we'll guide you through the essential system options that we recommend new users employ to get the most out of your SolidWorks experience. System options control the behavior of the SolidWorks software. Unlike document properties, which are specific to each file, these settings will be consistent across all projects and models opened on the logged in user account. The cog icon at the top of the screen houses these system options. In here is an extensive menu, broken down into relevant tabs. We're working with the default settings currently, so let's have a look at which options are helpful to change. Under the General tab, it's worth enabling the freeze bar. This will turn on the orange freeze bar within the Feature Manager tree. Dragging this bar down the tree will lock the features above it, preventing them from rebuilding and protecting them from any accidental changes. Within the Drawings tab, check the box to show the sheet format dialog when adding a new sheet. This allows you to browse to a different sheet format or select the same one as the current sheet from the pop-up menu when adding a new sheet to the drawing. Without this checked, the new sheet will automatically display the sheet format of the currently viewed sheet. When working with section, auxiliary, and detail views, it's helpful to reuse view letters from deleted views. Check this box to allow recreated views to use the first available letter by default. You can always change the letter manually if you want to skip a letter, but this helps to speed up modifying drawing layouts and views. Removing the gradient from the SolidWorks background increases the contrast to help you see your model more clearly. It also makes it easier to remove the background from screenshots should they be needed for any presentations. Under the Colors tab, select the viewport background from the list. Edit the color and choose white. Under the Background Appearance section, select Plain to use the color specified by viewport background. A key setting for any SolidWorks user is the auto-rotate view normal to sketch plane. Found in the Sketch tab, this checkbox will automatically reorient your model so you are looking directly at the face or plane you are trying to sketch on. It's a helpful setting that removes a few extra clicks and keeps you looking in the right direction. If you're used to entering dimensions as you draw sketch lines, then you may wish to turn on the on-screen numeric input. Check the box within the Sketch tab to enable this. You should now be able to type the dimension into the box alongside the sketch line that you're creating. This is a great setting for recreating a familiar working environment, but it may limit your workflow while sketching, as keyboard shortcuts can't be used while creating sketch geometry with the on-screen numeric input enabled. If you do want to experiment with keyboard shortcuts or are a brand new CAD user, then it's worth leaving this box unchecked as you embark on your SolidWorks journey. Checking the option to use fully defined sketches will ensure that you never leave a sketch underdefined. SolidWorks will prompt you before making a feature from or exiting a sketch. Fully defined sketches are the backbone of high-quality SolidWorks models. And this option is especially recommended for ex-Creo users to create a more familiar environment. With this option, you'll never leave a sketch vulnerable. To make the most of sketch geometry, ensure that Enable Snapping is checked from the Sketch Relations and Snaps tab. This allows you to quickly create relations to points, lines, and edges to enhance your modeling and accuracy. Verification on rebuild checks your model geometry more thoroughly for errors. This greatly increases rebuild times and can flag up some small errors in geometry. These won't necessarily impact your model's accuracy, but can cause a series of issues in your feature manager tree. To improve performance, speed up rebuilding time, and avoid a feature tree full of errors, turn this option off. When creating a new part from inside an assembly, it can be helpful to save it as a new file immediately. Selecting the Save New Components to External Files option from the Assemblies tab makes SolidWorks prompt you to save these on creation. This helps to keep track of all of your components within your file browser and stay organized. As you get more experienced with SolidWorks, you'll discover a whole world of custom templates that you can get creative with. While you're starting out though, it's best to keep things simple and straightforward so you don't get lost. In the Default Templates tab, make sure to select Always Use These Default Templates. This will ensure that the templates specified above will be automatically used as the default part, assembly, and drawing documents when you start a new file. There are a number of file locations within SolidWorks which control various parameters, lists, and templates. It's really important to manage and keep these folders organized, especially when using custom templates. Check out our video within My Solid Solutions about creating an organized and simple SolidWorks folder structure, and learn how to manage these file locations effectively. It's not just file locations that benefit from good management. Take care of your feature manager tree and rename features as you go. Within the feature manager options, check the option to name the feature on creation and keep track of your modeling process and easily identify your features. Within that feature manager tab, also turn on arrow key navigation. This allows you to move between the tree items with the keyboard arrow keys. Move vertically with the up and down arrows and expand and collapse features with the right and left arrows. The options within the Spin Box Increments tab control the value moved by the spin dials and scroll wheel when in dimension boxes. By default, these are set to 10mm. Setting this to 1mm gives an extra level of control to dimensioning. When using a spin box, hold Ctrl to increase the value by an order of magnitude. Hold Alt and the default value will decrease by a similar order of magnitude. Backup and Recover contains a life-saving tool. Make sure to turn on the number of backup copies per document. We recommend setting this to at least 2, depending on the size of your model files and storage space. This option saves the file data from the most recent save as a temporary file. These can be saved to a specific folder or to the same location as the original file. These backups can then be accessed in the event of a crash or corruption to save you time and worry, guarding against losing a day's work or more. Make sure to save often to minimize the risk of losing large amounts of work. It's important to note that this is not an autosave. Backups are only created when files are saved manually and are kept until a specific time frame has passed, or unless you specify them to be kept indefinitely. Messages, errors, and warnings contains a box of permanently dismissed messages. Occasionally, you may be performing an action that SolidWorks needs to warn you about. And when you do this action repeatedly, you may be tempted to click Don't Show Again to prevent repeat warnings. Try to avoid permanently dismissing these messages, as they may be warning you about important errors. You can re-show permanently dismissed messages by checking the box next to the title of the dismissed message. Once you click OK, these messages will start to appear again when appropriate. SolidWorks can open far more than just part, assembly, and drawing files. The Import tab contains controls for a variety of these file types. Before importing other files into SolidWorks, ensure that 3D Interconnect is turned off. This allows you to interact with the imported file as a SolidWorks part file and removes the link to the original, allowing large data to be handled more quickly and easily. Visit My Solid Solutions to learn more about importing specific file types. Remember, if you ever get stuck trying to find a setting, search for keywords in the search bar. Clicking on the result will take you to the options location and highlight it for you. Settings are not just limited to the system options cog. Here are a few bonus options that will help you along your SolidWorks journey. In the Heads Up toolbar, Real View Graphics can be enabled to give a more photorealistic look to your model. Be aware that you must have a recommended graphics card installed to enable this option. Give us a call if you need a hand checking your graphics card or updating it to the latest version. The Command Manager and mouse and keyboard shortcuts can all be customised via the drop-down next to the Options cog. Drag your favourite commands onto relevant tabs for easy access, and set up shortcuts to personalise and enhance your SolidWorks workflow. Add-ins can be controlled by the drop-down too. Select any that you frequently use to load up on startup, or turn them all off on startup to improve your software opening time. And finally, you can take your customised SolidWorks environment with you anywhere. Once you've made all the changes you want, you can save settings out to a file with the Copy Settings wizard found under the cog dropdown in Save Restore Settings. These files can then be imported using the same wizard on any machine. Selecting each tick box will save your whole SolidWorks environment, shortcuts, toolbars, and all. This makes it really easy to have your same settings on multiple machines, or keep multiple users comfortable on a single machine. It's good practice to save these to a specific settings folder within your single SolidWorks folder. There is no single correct way to customize SolidWorks, but these recommended settings should help you to get comfortable within your SolidWorks environment and speed up your workflow so that you can focus on designing, modeling, and engineering a brighter future.